I would like the Nigeria Professional Football League. Let's go to the continental competitions now, where Enyimba Football Club of Abadish, we'll call them the People's Elephants. They gave an elephant performance against Vitalo of Burundi, right there in Port Harcourt at the Aduke Amaimaka Stadium. 5-1. And Chinasia, it got sweeter because Mfonudo, as it a form that Coach Aigbogun cannot even explain.
Yeah, you know, Ofamdo is a player we all saw two seasons ago. Mm. We saw his capability, how he scored lots of goals in the professional league. And right now, last season he was sort of hot and cold. He was being hot and cold. He wasn't the Ofamdo we all saw the previous season.
I think
but
it's
now,
the injury that's begin- set
yeah, yeah,
the
he's beginning
the
to show that, you know what, the saying where which goes that form is... it's temporary, but class is permanent. So he's going to show you that he's a classy player. He has it in him, and he will keep getting the goals where they
so that's what it is. But that's not the same story for what it was, because they lost right there at the Warri Township Stadium to Al-Merrikh of Sudan by a single goal. And then it's disappointing because Warri was considered in the 18th minute and couldn't get back to that game. Paul Aigbogun was the former coach, was at Warri last season. He's now the coach of Enyimba Football Club, so it's a mixed fortunes for him. But he joins us now to talk about the game between Enyimba and Vitalo. Good morning, coach, and welcome to the program.
Good morning.
Okay. We're trying to understand what happened to your team against that Burundian side. Was it the desire to show that we actually have quality in Nigeria when talking about our continental competitions?
No, I think, you know, all along we have been trying to assemble kind of a new team together since I came in this season. I think for most of the games we have been playing well, but created so many chances. We haven't been taking them, and thank God yesterday we took every chance, or almost every chance that came our way.
Now let's talk about the new form that your strikers have gotten into. We know your style of play. You take it easy when you get to a club, and then there you go. They start doing everything. What are you saying to the strikers? They're getting the goals.
I think all along we've kept working on them. We know the quality of the players that we have here. And at times, when a team starts the season, they don't all start on fire. But I know it's just a matter of time before the quality of striker that we have before they all pick up. And as I said yesterday, it all came together. So
when your team goes to Burundi, you still gonna take it as business, or you just say just go out there and then make sure you get to the next round?
Yeah, of course. I mean, it's another game. The game yesterday is over. I'm sure it's not going to be an easy game for us over there. So we're going to face it with a lot of fearlessness and preparation. But I'm sure that if we prepare well and focus with the right attitude, we should come out okay.
Congratulations, coach, on the victory. And as wishing Enyimba Football Club all the best, not just in the league, but also in the CAF Champions League. So that's it, Coach Paul Aigbogun. I don't know about you guys, but when I saw that result, we haven't seen that in a very long time for Nigerian teams in the continent. It made me feel good.
Yeah, they're playing at home. So, I mean, you have all the time and all the support and everything you have. If Warriors were playing Emirates, I knew if Warriors had won that game, it would have been a shocker. Because, you know,
why would it be a shocker? Emirates, I know.
They're not in the same class. I mean, when you talk about the continent,
they could
exactly.
They could have gotten.
But if Enyimba had failed to beat, I mean, Burundi.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So,
I'm
not taking anything away from the Burundians, but apparently, it's actually good that they got that sort of result, you know, to stamp your authority over teams like this, so that when. The name Enyimba should draw some sort of a tremor amongst the minos, so-called minos in football. And I think that they came out to achieve that particular feat.
On the continent also, Warriors would be like Mino, and that's why Merrick actually came and said, Balogo. But I think they could have done better. If you check Warriors, even in the league and also in the continent, they're really not doing so well. I felt, you know, you had a bye into the second round. You had all the time, you know. You can to actually prepare for this game. And you're playing the first leg at home. So was more like a double advantage for them. But those guys came in here and... Well.
That's why you should worry for them. I think it's all about structure. When you have the right structure in place, one thing about Enyimba is if they are not winning, something about their history just makes you comfortable. You just know that this club, they might just, you know, spring something. And don't say Vitalo is a small team. In the CAF Champions League...
I said so.
Yeah, I know. Because in the CAF... Look at what Vipers almost did. Cup Vipers did, you know. So I think it's a good result for them. And Warren Wolves should also look at it and say,
oh, the tie is by no means over. It's not over by long. I tell Warren Wolves to go to, you know, to go over there and actually, you know, get a result. Because at the end of the day, there's a way you might look at it. This Almeric team might get complacent. You know, they've come here, they've done hard work, they've gotten a 1-0 victory. They might believe they will come over to the go home and they'll deal with Warri Wolves. And if Warri Wolves really prepare for that game, they can actually surprise them. So it's, I'm not writing them off at all.
If the surprise happened, that would just be Warri Wolves were lucky.
I mean,
the way and manner in which most of their top players left wasn't really cool for me. I mean, their players can leave, but the way they're leaving is really not the best way players should leave a club. Because Warri Wolves is a very big club. What happened to them in pre-season and all that, it's something that you wouldn't want to hear from a club as big as Warri Wolves.
Yeah, but it happens sometimes, you know, players leave for different reasons. You're not in, you're not part of the club, you're not part of the administration to know why they actually left. So I think Warri Wolves, they are going through a phase right now, but they will bounce back.
They will bounce back. So that's it in the CAF Champions League. Bittersweet experience for Nigeria. Embers part very sweet. Warri Wolves bitter. Ah, Nigerians are not. They're smiling a bit in the CAF Confederations Cup because Nasarawa United, they had to hold on to a 1-0 victory over Club Sportif Constantinoy of Algeria. Let's see. This is another serious business for Nasarawa United when they go play the second leg. And I listened to some of the players and they said, look, if we can win 1-0 here, why can't we win 1-0? We'll hold on to our victory. That's the spirit that you have.
If you want to get any victory at home in a two-legged game, I think 1-0, any victory that is by a single goal margin, I think 1-0 should be the best because it means that the other team didn't get an away goal. And you can get over there. You know, you score one goal, these guys will be needing three. So I think that's an incentive already for Nasarawa United that they can go there and do something, you know, maybe get a goal and defend, smash and grab, hold them back and hit them on the counter.
Okay, they can do that, smash and grab. Now, talking about something that's happened the weekend.
No, we'll leave that on to you. We'll leave that on to you. What happened over the weekend?
Okay, I mean, if Flamingos won, I mean, come on, six goes to nothing. You know, we're not even talking about the victory. We knew where they were going to win. We're thinking of how many goals they were going to score. Because
I told you.
But they had to score about four goals and of course another player scoring two goals. Just two players scoring the six goals. I mean, the South Africans definitely wasn't really happy about that because the Flamingos were all out to ensure that playing at home, let's take advantage of this and win big. So when you get to South Africa, whatever happens, you know you already are into the next round. So a big up for the Flamingos for being able to put smiles on the faces of Nigerians.
What a story for the Flamingos, and we said it that with the Flamingos, Chinna said, I don't know about you, I just go to sleep. Flamingos
Falcons. And you wait for the results.
Lately, it's just Super Falcons. I'll take coffee, I'll stand up to watch this.
About a decade ago when Super Falcons were also that dominant on the continent. So the Flamingos, the Falconets, you can actually most times say they will do their job and they will go through.
That's right.
Yeah, it's always cool when your captain, you know, had to do most of the hard work and ensure that everything comes well. I think that's what the Flamingos did in this one.
Leadership, you know, by example.
Yeah, she does scoring four goals in that one. I just love the joy, the celebrations. They've been in camp for like close to a month, and of course they justify that, you know, playing friendly games around and all that. And when it was the big day, they just have to prove that, yes, we are still the giant in Africa when it comes to playing on the 17th level. Now, the Super Falcons, of course, at the weekend, they played against All-Star Team 2-1. That one ended. So I think they're trying to come back now, all of them coming to camp and getting something good out of the games they're playing. They're also preparing for a crucial one, talking about the African Women's Championship. But that's this one is definitely what got all of us really happy on Saturday.
Of course, yeah. It should get us happy because Cecilia Omarabu. So we talked about the men. We've shown you the ladies. Football are getting our attention this morning on the show. Let's go over to Germany. See some highlights from the German Bundesliga. And we'll come back. We'll see what the papers are saying. We won't dwell much on it, but we'll just check it out. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Stay with us.